من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه وبركاته عليه فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة في الدين بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ونعوذ بالله من النار. أخوة في الله، أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله عز وجل كما أمرنا سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال أيضا: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحد وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. نصلي وأسلم أيضا على حبيبنا مصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي جاءنا بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون ولو كره الكافرون. When praises be to the Almighty Allah جل جلاله, the sustainer of the universe, the most merciful, the merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created you and I جل جلاله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has programmed everything here, the one who programmed everything here on earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has the program of you and the program of her and the program of all the people here upon earth. Either my brothers and sisters, let us have that fear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us have that faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لا بد علينا أن نتقي الله. It must all of us to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, بعوني سبحانه وتعالى, I'm sorry, I've come late because of some issues on the road. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith that السفر قطعة من العذاب. Safar, a journey, any journey that you've set up, any journey that you've programmed, whether you have the journey to anywhere, any place that you have programmed, it's a punishment. قِطْعَةٌ لَلْعَذَابِ. It's the part of punishment. يعني whenever you travel to any place, remember that you may face anything, any difficulty, anything that can disturb you. That's why you always recite the supplication. Whenever you want to go out, whenever you want to go abroad, you have to recite, to supplicate to the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, that can help you to pass through the difficulties, the challenges on the road. إخوة في الله, أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل. Please, my brothers and sisters, we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حيثما كنت, in any situation, in any place, in any location, wherever you are, you have to have that faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing me, يراني في كل حال وفي كل مكان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is observing you. The cameras of Allah are very, very targeting you. They're targeting you, my brother. You have to have that fear into your heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing me. Ethan, هذا, that thing of having the faith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing you, it will help you from doing any obedience, from doing any sin. You have to follow the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, inshallah, we're going to see about one thing in Islam, and that's brotherhood in Islam. That's the topic of today, with you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't understand English very well, but I try my level best. I don't mean that I have to share it with my brothers, so that we can get a good communication, so that you understand a little bit of Islam. I'm sorry if I'm making any mistake, it's normal. Don't laugh at me. I'm just praying my youngest brothers. A brother in Islam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages us, all of us. He taught us about the goodness and the benefits of good brother in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, all of us. We are one person. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةِ فِي صُحْبَةِ الْحُجُرَاتِ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخْوَيْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Holy Quran that إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةِ. Really, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةِ. Muslims, all believers are brothers. All believers are brothers. As long as someone has أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, as long that he's a Muslim, he is your brother, she is your sister. That's our topic today. The world people are different. People have differences in deen. Spirituality, people have differences in deen, in religion. You may be understanding this hadith differently, and I understand it differently. But that those differences will never separate us. We have to support, we have to promote, propagate love and peace plus brotherhood. We should stop propagating hatred. Let us love each other, my brothers and sisters. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. All believers are brothers. We don't consider the color, whether you're black or brown or blue or blue, any color that you are in, any situation, any occupation, you have to know that he is my brother, she is my sister. Leave alone the occupation, whether you're manager or supervisor or employer, you have to be one person. That is Al-Islam. We have to have that brotherhood in our hearts. That he is my brother, she is my sister. That's the only weapon we have, we as Muslims in Uganda or in the world. I've told you that we have differences in knowledge, understanding, something, some issues about Islam. You may be having different things, and I have different things, but those differences will never separate us. مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ بَعْدِي فَسَيَرَى اِخْتِلَاقًا كَلِمًا. My brothers, let us have that love, peace. That's Islam. People are different. We are different. We have different heads. You'll never understand as I understand. We have different heads, different brain. Then my brother, you have to know that he is your brother, she is your sister. That's the only line that we are going to pass through in this subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only road, the only path that will help us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to grant us Jannah. Wa nas'alullahu Jannah. Allahumma ameen. We pray to Allah so that he can grant us Jannah. Yawm al-Qiyamah. Then my brothers, brotherhood is very important. Islamically, at home, your family, your children, your brother, people are separated everywhere in the world. At home, you have 3-2 weeks without communicating to your brother because he said so and I said so. That's why you don't even to see him. You don't even to see his missed call. You don't want even to open his WhatsApp message because he said so about you and you want to say so about him. That's why you are separated. We have to stop such issues. We are Muslims. You can't get appetite for food when you're angry, when you are mad at your brother. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us only 3 days. Whenever someone accuses you, or someone disturbs you or abuses you, you are not supposed to sleep without forgiving him or her. That's Islam, brotherhood. Take 2 minutes, 3 minutes, forgive your brother. That's Islam. But a lot of people here, they can finish even a year, month, up to century without forgiving themselves. Just because he did something. Just because my wife said such and such. And I tried to take my feelings. Because my wife said so, and my brother said so, that's why we're no longer communicating. That's not the truth, my brother. Let us have that brotherhood in Islam. Spiritual spirit. Yeah, in Islam, it's the deen of peace. It has peace. In Islam is where we find peace. In Islam is where you will find the comfort. That's my brother, alhamdulillah, I have a brother. In any problem, in any difficulty, he or she will help me. That's brotherhood. Never see your occupation, never see your level of education, never see brotherhood first. إنما المؤمنون إخوة. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الخلق الله أفضل صلوات الله وسلامه وبركاته عليه. When he went to Mecca to Medina, from Mecca to Medina, the so-called Hijra, when he went to Medina, he found the Muslims were separated. When the people in Medina said, these Muslims are coming to Medina, they are going to finish our food, they are going to finish our shelters, they are going to bring a lot of death here. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he reached Medina, بين المهاجرين والأنصار. He brought brotherhood. That's now Sahabi, you go and sleep with your brother. Give him a room. And they did so. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved them. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved them. And they still loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They loved the deen. But here, my brothers, we are living in a country where people are abusing themselves. Those sheikhs are abusing themselves. The incident that what happened recently here, 2 days back, or 1 day back, if I'm not confused, or forgot, it was about Maulid. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The birthday of the Prophet. People celebrating, others they didn't celebrate. Those are just differences in knowledge, understanding. But people are abusing themselves. Why did you celebrate Maulid? Why did you enter Kafir? You are Kafir, my brother. How can you say and you tell your brother that he's a Kafir? Because he celebrated Maulid al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Me as Sulaiman Malik, I don't celebrate it. But I can't abuse you, a brother of mine who celebrates Maulid. I have to teach him the truth about Maulid. But don't never abuse your brother because he took the other side and he took the different side. We are saying that your brothers are astray because he is such and such. Whether your brother is a drunk or is a thief or has any bad manner, never abuse him, never hate him. You have to hate the sin that he did, but not the person. Never. That's not Islam. Because you have 2-3 juzus in the head, you have 2 ahadith, you start abusing people, he is a kafir, and a munafiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Hujurat, he said that, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَامِ. My brothers, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَامِ. Never give other people the nicknames. Never nickname people that he's a kafir because his trouser is low. Oh, his trouser is down from the ankle. Never say that. If he raised, if he didn't teach him, so that he can go, he can follow the path of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam without abusing, without neglecting people, without. Let us be brothers and sisters in Islam. Whenever we do such a thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us. Wallahi, we love us subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of the time, my brothers, I'm sorry I came late, but I've tried my level best, Ya'awni subhanahu wa ta'ala, to deliver some of my knowledge, a little knowledge I have, I've delivered some to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put ease and make it ease, meaning subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that I'm among us, we get some people who understand such a word. Allahumma, أقول قولي هذا, أستغفر الله لي ولكم. وسلم سلم من كل ذنب فاستغفر الله انه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم حتى ان يدعو حميما وتنبلا استغفر الله وسلم brother, sister. We praise the Almighty again. Was given us, was given us the second chance. Still, we are still alive. We are still listening to His beautiful words. نسأل الله أن يتقبل. اللهم in these many minutes, like five, let me try to summarize the words that we have said. Islam, we don't consider a lot of words. We just talk little that will make people understand, that will people get benefits in them. Than talking a lot while abusing people, accusing people. You are kafir, you are munafiq, you are mubtadi', because we celebrated the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have to teach those people. They are our elders, they are our grandpapas, grandmamas. We have to give them that respect. And we teach them with a lot of respect and good morals plus the behaviors. Whenever you combine all those, you will get a good sheikh, you will get a good student. Be this subhanahu wa ta'ala. But a lot of people, they want to be educated, they want to have a lot of knowledge with bad manners. They want to make their names on social media just by abusing people. Wallahi al-azim, you will never become a great scholar in Islam. You will never become a good student in Islam when you are propagating hatred in Muslim among Muslims. You are propagating hatred. You are propagating abusive ilm to the ummah. You will never be a good scholar. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawzi, Abu Hanifa, Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Abu Hanifa, Nu'man bin Thabit, Imam Shafi'i, Muhammad bin Isa Shafi'i, Imam Malik, Malik bin Anas, Malik bin Abu Alim. Wallahi ma fa'alu hada. He didn't abuse themselves. By the way, perhaps they had their differences in knowledge, understanding hadith, but they didn't abuse themselves. I told you that Imam Shafi'i was taught by Imam Malik. Malina, but they didn't abuse themselves. But the followers, we have two hadith, even if you don't know even Sahih or Da'if, we are here abusing the generation, removing this one from Jannah, better this one from Jannah. That's not true, my brothers. We have to have that yaqoon. We have to help each other's brothers. We have to save our brothers who have problems, we have to save them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is my last ayah, told us in the Quran al-Kareem that anyone who saves the life of a person, فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَ النَّاسَ بِالْمِنَّا. Anyone who will come out and help or save someone's life, the ayah told us, أَحْيَا. Allah said that the one who will give life to anyone. That's why Mufassirun told us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who is supposed to give life. But here we're talking about Ahya, the one who will save someone's life.